Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 1 of Project Infinity. Today I am joined again with Swans, just like in the channel server introduction, because I'm pretty much recording this straight after just because I want to have a lot of cool stuff done today. Don't you think? Yes, I'm talking to you.
For me?
Yes.
Hey, hello.
Hello.
Yeah, sounds fun.
Yes.
And hello, YouTubes.
Hello. Yes. For those wondering, we both are Dutch and we both have horrible accents. Don't blame us. Blame him, not me. So, pretty much...
As always, blame him.
Yeah. Or blame Tom and Butter, another player on the server. That's my usual catchphrase. But, pretty much what I want to do today is quickly run you by with what we already have on the server and then get started doing some actual business, because otherwise I will be annoying Swans way too much by, you know, wasting his time.
Yeah, go chop wood for me. I need
later.
Wood.
Hold on. Calm down. So, pretty much, some of this stuff is already kind of basic startup stuff, as most of the materials that you can see right here are imported from Gastonia Eagle's stream server. He also, streams on the Infinity Involved modpack. But he decided to port some of his stuff over to this world so he can both stream on this world and we can play on it all together. So that's pretty cool. So let's see, what do we have? First of all, we got some basic Tinker's Construct stuff, being the stencil table, pattern chest, part builder, and the tool forge, so we can already make some very powerful weapons if we want. We got ourselves a coke oven and a blast furnace from Immersive Engineering, meaning we can get creosote and steel out of this. Couple of barrels, some very basic power generation, as we got one water reel outside right here. I believe it's just one, or I don't know how big these things are normally, but...
They are three.
Oh, are there three? Oh. Then
yeah, there
we
are
have,
three.
Then we have three. Pretty cool. So that should generate us around 90 RF per tick, if I'm correct, knowing my maths and all. Pretty cool. Little bed box right here, connected to a rock crusher, connected to some industrial craft machines. Which is something I am definitely needing to get used to, because it has been over, I'd say, 1.5 years, 2 years, since I've actually messed with industrial craft. So, yeah, definitely need to catch up with some of that stuff. Obsidian chest for some ores, apparently. Just a bunch of random junk chests, it seems. A couple of barrels and some more random chests. And a little tool rack with a engineering's hammer and a... Let Lumber X, which ones want me to use way too often right now. So, yeah, it's pretty cool. So probably what I will do is see if I can gather some wood for us, just to get some basic materials going, so we can actually, you know, work on making some more proper housing, perhaps. Or, you know, just some general resources.
Yeah. But you're forgetting something to show.
Oh.
In this way.
That's because I have not been here, and I have no idea what is actually... around here.
Yeah, I made this earlier.
Oh.
But on the to-do list for everyone is to make something that generates water, because it'll dry up.
Wait, what?
Say hello to our farms.
Cool, farms. But what do you mean water dries up?
Well, you see the sprinklers. The sprinklers is what's keeping this ready.
Yeah, yeah.
So in order for the sprinklers to work, this nice water tank needs water in it.
Yeah.
Currently, the only way to get water in it, if it's raining, water will go in.
Mm-hmm.
And manually by moving buckets of water in there.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Not so much fun.
No.
Then that might be something I am able to work on a little bit later. Cool. So what is our main type of tree that we're using? Spruce or...
At the moment...
Oak?
Everything, but I want to go over into actual apple oak, because then we also get the apples.
Oh yeah, true. But you still just want to use like regular oak as a, you know, building material or whatever.
Yep.
Okay, cool. So then I will leave these spruce sitting where it is, just so we don't have two different barrels for two different types of wood. And achievement: getting wood. Always nice to start so off somewhere. So I'm really hoping to get some very fancy stuff in this series going together, mainly because of the idea which I talked about in the introduction of the channel, which is being a very communal built and thought of server. So just imagine things like a communal power line running through our village where everyone is able to both take a bit of power from the network but also send power back into the network if they have way too much in trade, of course, for whatever you want to get in return of sending the power over to those who need it. And just a lot of general trading like that, maybe even get some sort of economy going between all the users on the server. And yeah, just bit of role playing, who knows? We'll see what we can do in the end. Just the main important thing to keep in mind is just to have a lot of fun with all the players that will be on the server hopefully soon, because with just us two, there is not much to do. So, is there already some place thought out where we actually want to make that village swans?
Yeah, the biome that if you go outside of the place here, so you're currently to the south, I see. If you go north, you can see it on the minimap maybe a bit.
Nor I don't see anything on the minimap, but I do see a
Yeah,
building
if
right
you
here.
go straight, that building, that's going to be the town hall.
Oh, so this is
And the
seriously going to.
idea is that we make our village over in this biome here, the Forest Hills biome.
Okay, that's a weird location for a village. I would expect something like a place or something to work better, but hey, I'm not the mayor, so.
Yep, neither am I. I am just a farmer, mostly. And currently the sorter of everything inventory-wise because it was a mess.
I can definitely imagine. So, that's also something I need to really think about, what role I want to have on this server. Because the last time I played in a sort of role-playing village type of world was when I played Utopia Cubed. And there I was like this evil mage type of thingy. I was like the most expert person in Talmcraft. I knew everything. All the combinations. I had the most awesome, crazy, OP one stuff. So yeah, pretty cool. That's also something that I definitely enjoy doing. So who knows? Maybe something along those lines might be interesting, or maybe some other, either a tech mod or a magic mod, or let me know in the comment section below what you guys think I should do. But for now, chopping wood. So how much wood do you actually need me to get once?
Well, I need to get a number of stuffs in order to get the stuff set up, the chest room, because I'm making basically this is like the start of a warehouse, kind of.
Okay, so we really want to have like a warehouse eventually built inside of these mountains.
I don't know what we want, and something to discuss, but for now, currently, I was like, let's get some stuff that's where we're gonna need a lot and put that in the first entrance, say, and also the machines a bit haphazardly everywhere here. And eventually we'll port everything over and make nice stuff, but yeah, I wanted to have more storage space, location, and sorting, so I made this
Makes
so
sense.
that in the future we can find stuff at least and not like it's now.
Yeah, sounds cool. So I currently got that amount. Almost 4 stacks.
Nice.
And
At
some
least some
rubber tree
stuff.
saplings and rubber and other stuff. And I guess I should kind of sort this stuff too and not just put it randomly everywhere.
Yes, please.
So
I mean,
yeah.
it's gotta be better sorted stuff later, but for now, it's. Yeah.
Yeah, I gotcha. So I guess I will quickly sleep through the night, see what I can do next. I will be right back. Alright guys. So first of all, the thing that I want to get started is getting some basic tools. Because of course that might be kinda useful if I want to advance in any way in the game, or being able to even help anyone else. So as we already had some bronze laying around, I decided to make some bronze tools just to get started. I'm not sure. I believe I need one more ingot of bronze actually to melt down. Probably derped up right there. So let me quickly get one more. Bronze, there we go. So these tools that I will be making won't be like too extremely advanced or fancy or whatever, but just be functional enough to do what I want them to do right now. So yeah, pretty cool. So let's see. tool forge. I need a tool binding for the pickaxe and for the shovel and the hatchet. I don't. Okay, makes sense. So I need to make only one. Not right there. Put that away. Do we even have a binding? Oh yeah, we do. I guess I can just make it out of what's better. Apparently stone is better. So stone binding. And a piece of stone shard that I don't need. So let's see. Get some sticks. And one more. There we go. And put it together. So first of all, we have ourselves a very basic pickaxe. A very basic axe. Or hatchet, as you might call it. And hopefully the bronze is melted already. It has. Get a shovel cast going. There we go. So are you still going on sorting all the stuff, I see?
Yep.
Aha. Thank you. One stick, one shovel. There we go. Awesome stuff. So that means that I at least can get some basic stuff going on. So I had a couple of ideas of what I want to do in this season. Because like I said, the last few times I have already messed with Tomcraft. And even though, you know, you kind of get used to the basic research and everything, it does stay, you know, just stay a lot of fun. And especially because we have a couple of add-ons that I've never messed around with before. If I look up, let's see, Tom... we have Tomcraft, of course. We have Tomic Exploration, which I have never messed around with before. So that might be a cool mod to, you know, check around and see what kind of things it can do. Then, of course, we have Tomic Tinkerer, which is something I have played around with, but it has been a while. So yeah, pretty cool. And of course, we have Tomic Energistics, which I messed around with on the previous Project Gamma server before. So, yeah, might be a cool thing to just get at least the basics of Tomcraft going. Maybe even in this episode, like the table and a basic wand. So, yeah, should be pretty cool. So, I don't suppose we already have some greatwood logs laying around somewhere.
Did you know? No idea, but that just reminded me I need to make a Tomcraft chest.
A Tomcraft, ah, yeah. That might be a good idea. Or maybe just put it next to the Tomcraft area that I am going to be using.
Yeah, it's going to be moved later on.
Okay.
But this is just general stuff for everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm also going to be putting most likely my basic Tomcraft stuff right here and then moving it to a final place some other time once we actually, you know, have it. So let's see, how do I make this? I need greatwood planks, which I... Well... Can really only get them through a sawmill or a arcane work table that requires V. Really?
Yep. Welcome to this mod.
And I don't suppose we already have a some sort of method for that. Make a sawmill. Sawmill is required. Iron axe, some of the copper gears, redstone reception coil, and again that overly difficult to make machine frame, which requires an assembly table, which requires an iron chipset, a tin gear, a basic circuit, some crushed obsidian, and a dense plate. Should I make one? Do you think that would be worth its once?
Yeah, we're gonna use it for other stuff too, so.
Yeah, I guess so.
Go ahead.
Cool. So let's see, machine frame. Like I said, it requires some dense refined iron, which is 9 pieces of steel in one of these, what's it called? Compressor? No, plate former. That's the, or metal former, that's the one. I need to put it to rolling, cutting, extruding. I think rolling mode is the one that I need. Let's hope so. Like I said, it's been almost 1.5 to 2 years since I've actually messed with Industrial Craft 2 before. So, yeah. Oh, yeah. Refined iron plates. Awesome. Crushed obsidian. I can get that quite easily from getting some obsidian in this crusher. Makes sense. Iron chipsets. Do we have a laser setup?
No.
I thought we had a laser though.
Yeah,
Oh, hey, we
it's in
do.
the appropriate chest.
Oh, nice. Then I guess I can just make some temporarily set up somewhere. I have no idea. Does this work? Apparently, it does not. I have no idea how to use this stuff. This doesn't work either. Man, immersive engineering. Why are you so difficult? Let's see. Do we have some more immersive engineering stuff somewhere?
I'm still sorting.
Okay. Thank you again, though. I don't know. MV wire connector. So, I think that's the thing that I need. At least I think so. So let's
Yeah,
see.
that's true.
Okay. So in theory, then I could put it like right there, and then this thing connected to that or something along those lines. Okay, guys, let me quickly do some research into this before I get too crazy. Alright, guys, so I think I got myself the most difficult component of all, which is the machine frame. For this machine frame, like I already mentioned, it requires a lot of different materials like the dense refined iron plate, some crushed obsidian, a basic circuit board, tin gears, and an iron chipset. And for that, I even had to make myself a carpenter just to actually get this recipe going. So, yeah. That's pretty cool. And also had to reset up all this laser stuff just so we can make well, the actual machine frames. So I'm recording this a little bit later, so currently we got Gastonia, Eagle, Udelder, and Swans back on the server. Currently not on TeamSpeak though, so yeah, thanks. Cool anyway. So yeah, like I said, today I want to make the sawmill. So that should be pretty cool. So let's see, I need one of these things. I need some copper gears. I even had to do some more mining for some copper as we were surprisingly low. And I need an iron axe, which is actually not too bad to make. So let's see, should be able to do that. Oh, not like that, of course. Derp. Just like so. Let me quickly put. Oh, I see a creeper. Let me put this copper in here and run away just so it doesn't explode. Just so I can actually get working on the sawmill. So then I need to make one of these fancy thingies. Here we go. Okay, something just exploded. That's never too good. Then I need one machine frame, an axe, and two pieces of wood. Cool stuff. And yep, then all I need is the gears. So oh, let me also get my spawn point set right here because I haven't done that before. Cool stuff. Takes just a moment to smelt up, but other than that, it's pretty cool. So yeah, well, I'll definitely want to see how far or what specific job I can do on this server, because like I mentioned in the introduction, we are trying to work together quite a lot. So if we have specific jobs for each person, I think we'll be able to, you know, have a bit more of a role-playing team, but also have more use of working together instead of just one person doing everything. You'll be forced to work together if one person has a specific job on the server, if you know what I mean. So yeah, I think it will be quite a lot of fun. Who's planting the greatwood trees? Not me, but still pretty useful that we actually have that. Molten copper. So that's one gear, and I believe I need two. So one, two. There we go. So then I should be able to put this thing together, like so. And we got ourselves a sawmill. I probably do also need to get myself some wires to hook it actually up to, well, power. So let's see. For that, I need some of these wires from Immersive Engineering, which requires a treated stick and four pieces of electrum. And also, Swans has been sorting a lot of our stuff out, so if you're watching this, thank you very much for doing that. It saves us a lot of time. So let's see. I would assume... Oh, never mind. One electric vehicle. We still had one laying around somewhere. I guess what I will do is get rid of this, put this right there. Then get ourselves one sawmill. Then just hook up one NV wire connector and hook this thingy up like so. And we're getting power. Woohoo! So I think what I should be able to do now is get myself this, let's see. To get going with Thumbcraft, I need the table and I need to get a wand soon. So that is just a stick and two iron caps. Let's make that first, actually. Because that's, you know, pretty easy to do. Two iron caps. And a stick gets me one iron capped wooden wand. Ooh, fancy stuff. And then I believe I needed to sawmill this stuff. I do actually, pretty cool. And we get sawdust, which I believe I can use this to make cardboard boxes, or is that, no wait, that's from mechanism. I don't think we have that actually. Let's see, one, two. One, two. I believe I actually need one more of these. Now I think of it. There we go. And I believe I need a pair of scribing tools. And let's see if there is a crazy, ridiculous recipe for that thingy, if I can find it in here. scribing tools. Just a glass file. Wait. Really? Glass files require mana glass. Really? So we must start with Thumbcraft first. Or with Petania first. Damn it! Actually, this can be a lot of fun because that means that between the episode or even the next episode, we will be able to start messing around with Petania. So that's a lot of fun, actually. So, yeah. Let's see if I can find myself a place to actually put this for now. I mean, I don't think we have any more room inside. So maybe outside would be the way to go for now. Like I said, this is all temporary until we actually get a proper space for everything set up. So yeah, no need to worry too much about that. Ah! Stupid creeper. Stupid creeper. Stupid creeper. I got a hat called Blame the Community. Yay, cool hats. So let's see. One table here, one table here. And with a whack of my wand, I got myself a table. And I actually got myself some V in this wand. Pretty awesome. So yeah, I guess I don't have too much else to do for now. As we need to get started with Botania first before I'm able to actually... get going on the files that I need to actually make the scrubbing tools again. And yeah, that's quite a lot of stuff actually. So is there any chance I'm able to do this now? I don't think so. Let's see, Botania. If I recall correctly, for that I need one of those pure daisies. If I can find it somewhere. Pure daisy. Which is just four mystical leaves and a petal apothecary. Let's see, do we actually have some Botania stuff right here? Because if that's the case, that means that I will be able to get started with Botania already. And that can be quite a lot of fun, actually. Let's see, Botania. Oh, what do you know? We do have a couple of these things. Sweet. So, I mean, sure, let's get started on that. No one saying that I'm, you know, not allowed to do that. So, let's see. For that, I need myself a petal apothecary, which is a cauldron, some cobblestone slabs, a lot of cobblestone apparently. How much cobblestone do we have? We have quite some cobblestone. So I need three double compressed. Okay. That sounds doable, I guess. I hope. So, that's two. Then I need just a few more. Yes, as you can see, the recipes are really meant to be a lot more difficult than normally. But I guess that's just a lot of fun if you think about it, because of the whole, you know, more difficult infinity part of this game. So yeah, like I said, I need myself one petal apothecary. Oh, I need some stone slabs for that. So that's one of these, three of these, and right there, or what was it again? Oh no, a cauldron. There we go. One petal apothecary. And I need to get myself a wand of the forest, I believe it's called, which requires some living wood. So yeah, I don't actually have the materials to make that yet, because I need to get myself the petal apothecary first. So yeah, I'll probably just put it here for now. Get this going. Then I need to get myself one seed. Minecraft, mob drops, Agricraft. I'm not sure where anyone would put... Ah, Minecraft greenery. That makes quite some sense, actually. Why do we need blood in this thing? One pure daisy! Woohoo! So then what I can do is put this around here. Get some stone. Okay, wow, the server is really getting crowded today. That's a lot of fun, actually. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then for this, I will most likely just have to wait for this thing, you know, to actually smelt up. So do we have any more food for now? Any proper, you know, I like carrots as a food in-game, so it's cool. And I also need some living wood, so that means I need normal wood for that. And I believe we had a... Where is our wood, actually? Minecraft greenery is there. 8 pieces of wood. I think I can use this. Oh, wait. Never mind. I already had some wood on me. don't blame me. No, just don't. My fault. Sort of. Do I want to know why everyone is standing in this thingy? What are your three up to here? I have absolutely no idea what they're doing. These people are crazy. Woohoo! At least I got three of these. You need Botania to get into Tomcraft. Yeah, I'm up to something. Up to something bad or good. Depends on how you look at it. You tell her. Look up scribing tools. So, yeah. Pretty cool stuff. And actually, I still have no idea what they are doing here. Coagulated blood. I have no idea what that is. Coagulated blood. Things construct. Coagulated blood is blood combined with that and... What? It requires to have blood for most recipes? Okay, that's not just expert, but that's like properly hardcore. If you actually need, you know, blood for things like a logistics pipe network. That's crazy. Yeah, just insane stuff, but still a lot of fun. So I definitely hope that next episode I will be able to get on TeamSpeak with these folks, just so we are able to communicate a little bit faster. The people that don't have the sponsor set want to sleep already set. So let's see, then what I need to make, oh wait, we've got a crafting table right here now, is how do you make these sticks? Okay, like that. So I need to get 1, 2, 3 of these. And one of any color petal of your choosing. And just, you know, the pedals that you use will determine the color on this rod. So, you know, I like to have at least two different kinds of colors because it makes it look a lot fancier. Don't you think? Yeah, always. So then what I can do is get myself a diluted mana pool. And then what I can do is wrap up the episode right here. Yes. I know. Sorry, guys. So I definitely hope you guys enjoyed this episode so far. If you have, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below if you liked or disliked anything. And be sure to hit that thumbs up or down button depending on your, you know, choosing of your of this video. So yeah, pretty cool. So like always, if you have any questions, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. And for any more information, be sure to check out my website. So thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I will see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.